you say?
I said go ahead.
Let's be reasonable about this, Smith. Maybe I have been a little too hard on you. Would you like a little more time, a few special privileges?
Special privileges? Will you let the real Dr. Smith go?
Are you out of your mind?
No, Master, I am out of your mind. Will you let him go?
No! In a few minutes, it will be too late. He will be gone. Come back here! At once! Do you hear? Sir, you will turn to dust!
Go back to your little friend, Dr. Smith. Much as I would like to take your place, I know it could never be.
Excuse me, I must be off about my business.
Wait a minute.
What are you doing?
It's Dr. Smith, all right.
Are you sure?
Well, of course I'm Dr. Smith. Who did you think I was? Some sort of unreasonable facsimile?
Well, it could happen.
Yes, but for once I must say, we're all delighted to see you.
Indeed, and so you should be.
There have been moments when I prefer the other Dr. Smith. He was nice and polite.
Other Dr. Smith? Well, that's impossible, you ludicrous lump. There can only be one. Dr. Zachary Smith, and I am he. Dear, I'm not getting any reaction. Hand me the XYZ formula, please. Well, don't just stand there, you nickel-plated nincompoop. Get a move on.
It is impossible to do what you ask, because I do not understand what you want.
This is the XYZ formula.
It is? Strange. I thought it was the MQW formula.
A fat lot of help you are.
How's your experiment coming along, Dr. Smith?
Quite nicely, my dear. Success is almost within my grasp.
What are you trying to make here, Doctor? A new kind of chicken soup?
Spare me the people jokes, Major. They are typical of your crude humor. However, if you must know, I have invented a new type of rocket fuel for the Jupiter 2.
Really? Well, we could sure use it, but without plutonium, it can't work. And we don't have it.
There is enough plutonium here to get us to Earth and back, if necessary.
I've never seen it in liquid form before.
A scientific breakthrough of my own, Professor.
Discovered with the help of his brilliant assistant.
Silence, you bungler. Yes, I have accomplished the impossible. I have discovered a way to get us off this unhappy and unhealthy planet.
Dr. Smith, before we go placing a laurel wreath upon your noble brow, I've got a question.
You always have, Major.
Well, we've been trying for months to get off of this planet. Why didn't you dream up this rocket fuel before?
The answer is quite simple. I had not yet reached the depths of despair. When a man is driven to the limits of his endurance, he must act or perish.
When will your experiment be completed, Dr. Smith?
One final simple step, and I'm ready.
This I've got to see.
Now then, we are ready to test our new...